to Boga from Panama City required a ferry ride. Working on the Amador Causeway meant that I could buy my ferry ticket the day before, just to be safe. You can catch an express ferry for a little more money, but I decided to opt for the cheaper, longer ride. Ferries don't leave very often, and sometimes fill up, so definitely plan this part of your trip in advance. I was so happy when the ferry finally arrived at 10:30 a.m., filled to the brim with Isla Taboga residents heading to the mainland. I hurriedly got on to get a good seat. From the ferry dock, I could still see the Panama City skyline. The causeway is beautiful itself, but I was really excited to get to the tropical beach getaway of Isla Taboga. The water was calm, a deep blue with gentle ripples. The ferry trip only lasted about an hour. It wasn't long before Isla Taboga was in sight, the town squeezed between the shore and hilly peaks, the beach already covered by a dense pack of brightly colored umbrellas. Vibrant, picturesque houses nestled comfortably near the water. The dock was crowded with people awaiting the ferry. After meeting up with a new friend from Smithsonian, it wasn't long before we were exploring the narrow streets and colorful buildings of this island town. Isla Taboga is also known as the Island of Flowers, and as we explored it, it was easy to see why. Taboga offered such a different atmosphere than the hustle and bustle of Panama City. It was hard to believe we were only an hour away. There were no cars, no high-rises, just the gentle sea breeze and very friendly people. We attempted to make our way to Cerro de la Cruz, one of the highest peaks of Isla Taboga, but quickly succumbed to the Panamanian heat and humidity. So instead, we got lunch at a famous local spot named Callaloo. On the menu was a delicious lunch of plantain chips and ceviche mixto, a Panamanian specialty of raw mixed seafood and lime juice. And this meal came with a spectacular view. At the hottest point of the day, we made it to Taboga's beaches, to the right of the dock. We rented an umbrella and plunged into the gentle waters. Don't come to Taboga expecting great snorkeling. While the water was beautiful up top, below was quite murky. After a swim, I found a nearby restaurant selling refreshing piña coladas. A piña colada on a tropical beach? Stereotypical paradise achieved. Getting off Taboga Island was a little more challenging than expected. When I thought the last ferry of the day had arrived, there were still at least 100 more people that needed to be shuttled off. To my understanding, they sent another boat back for us. Despite waiting over an hour, it was still nice to revel in Taboga's island allure as the sun set on the dock. And the beauty of the ride home was breathtaking. Have you ever been to a tropical island? Tell me about it in the comments below. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more content. I'm Shayna, and I hope you enjoyed seeing the world from my point of view.